All right, as usual, I like to do a movie review of good movies I've seen. Only by request do I usually do bad movies. Why? Because, I don't really want to deal with negativity type of stuff. Deal with it through some close folks I know. I deal with it. Sometimes I get angry at a video game and just snap. Just recently, I let it go too far and I snapped a game. Don't worry, it wasn't something, blasphemous to break, like BioShock Infinite or Half-Life 2 or something like that. But anyways, I like to do movie reviews for movies I like. So this is continuing that. This is the movie review for Furry Vengeance. The movie is 92 minutes long, about standard length. That is an hour and 42 minutes. No, wait, no, sorry, not an hour and 42 minutes. Hour and 32 minutes. And then it came out in 2010, all right? So, over 4 years ago, it came out. Now, this stars Brendan Fraser, and Brendan Fraser's made a big name for himself. The Mummy, the Dudley Do-Right. He starred a role on Scrubs. That was a pretty touching part, if you've seen it. One of his better-known roles is George of the Jungle. He was in Journey to the Center of the Earth. And he is just a funny dude. I really enjoy him. This also has Brooke Shields, who's interesting. She plays his wife. And then we have a girl... Skylar something. She's gonna be in the movie The Duff. She was in this short-lived TV show called The Gates, but she's just a real treat to look at on the screen, and she's just got a very vibrant personality. Definitely brings some has a great personality on the screen. Then we have Ken Jeong from The Hangover, and then we have Rob Riggle, and we have the wonderful Rex from Toy Story, and also the prince, the bad one, the one that says, "Inconceivable!" Wallace Shawn. Also in a great movie I first saw him in called Just Like Dad. He plays the therapist. Now, so Brendan Fraser, he works with a company trying. He moves out into the forest. Basically, doesn't takes his family's lives away. They just live in the forest and stuff, so he could build this big estate, and it's gonna supposedly get lots of money and stuff. His son really doesn't like it. His wife tries to make the best out of it, but he's really busy with that. So, she tries to connect with the animals, but he doesn't really care about the animals. So then you see what they think, and they think that, he's like an evil guy. And they want to like go to war, and you'll see like the little thoughts of like war clips in their heads and stuff. It's very interesting. But you got the animal noises, but then they make it far-fetched and kind of make it kind of sound like a human in a weird noise. And then we got Brendan Fraser is trying to go and build this estate, and they all this stuff they tamper with stuff. They get birds and stuff to do pooping and to annoy him, and raccoons sneaking around doing stuff, sabotaging stuff. But it's just a really funny movie. Definitely family movie. But it's not just like cheesy. It is cheesy, but it's like I don't. I was laughing really hard. Also, it's got the fantastic Angela Kinsey, otherwise known as Angela from The Office. Also, she plays Ken Jeong's assistant, and I guess they're kind of there might be like a little spark or something kind of between them. So a lot of times he'll end up calling Brendan Fraser as character, and when the animals are attacking him, so Brendan Fraser's screaming and all this stuff, and Ken Jeong's character's like, "What's going on?" You know, freaking out and stuff, and getting kind of annoyed. But yeah, and then he tells his wife, Brooke Shields' character, that, you know, hey, these animals are doing this stuff, and she's like, "Wait, you're going crazy." So when she finally takes him to see a therapist, which is played by Wallace Shawn, and in the beginning, Rob Riggle's just in the kind of the beginning, just does not give a crap about the environment or animals or forest or anything, but he ends up just disappearing because the animals take care of him. They're very smart and clever, and it kind of gives you like an Ewoks vibe from Return of the Jedi with the environmental type of machines and stuff like that. Very natural like things. But the son ends up going to a library, and then he meets this girl, and they hang out a lot, and he doesn't start hating his life as much, right? But Brendan Fraser is just trying to get this estate built so he can make more money. Later on, he finds out that Ken Jeong's character wants him to stay longer so he can do phase two of the thing, which is supposedly for 4 years. Now, this is like, whoa, no, you know, Brooke Shields' character, and then the son is just like, no, that's not gonna happen. But it's got some great music. It's got, Don't Bring Me Down, Bruce. You know, it's got, at the very end, we get to see Insane in the Membrane, different, sung by someone different, but still good. And you have clips of stuff of them doing, of all the actors doing it. And at one point, you know, Brendan Fraser, he just all this stuff happens, and it's just hilarious. And there's always the workers all around, so they see this stuff that it happens, you know. It involves skunks and just all kinds of animals, bears. And I mean, it does have like CGI and stuff, but not so much to where it's cheesy. But it's just a really funny movie, man. If you like comedy, if you like Brendan Fraser, if you like George of the Jungle, I'm sure you'd love this. But George of the Jungle was interesting also as well, because it had the narrator and had the really intelligent ape, who would talk to George and stuff, and then you had Tookie Tookie, which is the toucan, and it was just really interesting. That's definitely one I would like to and love to own on DVD. But this is just a great movie. Brendan Fraser proves that he's just a wonderful, just enjoyable actor. He can be in action movies. He can be in funny movies. He can even play in drama slash just like really touching roles. But it's just a really just awesome movie. Definitely see it if you're a Brendan Fraser fan. If you're a Wallace Shawn fan, Angela Kinsey. And I also Angela Kinsey, you actually hear her speak in Indonesian. I heard in an interview where, because she was actually grew up in Indonesia, which I know that's crazy, but you look it up and you'll be or interviews and you'll find that out. That's true. But yeah, she speaks just, great thing. And Ken Jeong, he's funny, but then he's kind of like really high class, but then he's still got like kind of humanity like what's it called? He's still got kind of like his humanity and stuff like that. But yeah, this movie is just really awesome. These animals really just, man, they do some crazy stuff. Very clever and some stuff I haven't seen before, not just like cliche. But yeah, that's the Furry Vengeance movie review. Came out 5 years ago, man. That's crazy. Half a decade ago, man. All right, so obviously I loved this movie. Great cast, Brendan Fraser, Brooke Shields, Ken Jeong, Rob Riggle, Wallace Shawn, and the wonderful Angela Kinsey. Yeah, that's the review. I gotta wash my hands because I touched my cat. My eyes are irritated. Okay, so anyways, yeah, that's the review. Furry Vengeance, definitely watch it. It's on Netflix now. So you don't have to spend any money. If you have Netflix, then watch it. You'll like it. If you like Brendan Fraser, because this is just hilarious. All right, trust me. Unless you just don't like Brendan Fraser, which if you don't, what's wrong with you? I don't know. But at least have a good reason for not liking an actor, you know? So this is a great movie. Watch it. Definitely recommend it. Later.